extension, and they should have their wealth redistributed, and a moral order should be created, but that one cannot be created after I'm dead because everybody is doing the wrong thing and it reveals their heart. They do not have a good and noble heart. They do not have the life and martial art principles intact. First of all, if 100 people got together and planned for a year to run a train on a woman and kill her, should they not all be charged with first-degree murder at least? Okay? Premeditated first-degree murder. Corporations come together with full knowledge that their policies are going to cause 9 million people to starve to death a year, including 3 million children. Including 3 million children. They often fund wars and do all kinds of horrible activities, and the intelligence agencies help them do it. They do not arrest them for it. They do not interfere unless it's some kind of political gimmick or they did something, they're playing the game against each other. Everyone knows that that is this way. They have a eugenic agenda with a strong racial component. They do not want women to date handsome black heroes. And I'm the last one ever. And the last hero ever possible due to tech breeding and ill-gotten gain. Okay, so the least people can do is not reproduce. Every woman, especially if she's middle class or above, should get her tubes tied because they can afford it, and they should make sure not to reproduce. Why do you want to reproduce a child who's complicit with these global atrocities? Think about porn. Why is the porn industry so massive? Because people are being turned out. All other Americans live a cult of the flesh-like life where 50% of them aggressively stand firm for white cultural supremacy. Military, militia, Republicans, law enforcement, teachers, more aggressive skaters, frats, hate groups, politicians, political groups. At least 50% of these people, their heart is in it to a large degree on the spectrum. And they aggressively say who does that and stuff like that and enforce white cultural supremacy.
And people don't want to talk about it.
They play stupid about it, and it continues. The left is also very complicit.
And are vegans,
hippies, new age, ninnies, weak-willed people, techies, etc. It is an unholy alliance. And their job is to, as immigrants come here from other races especially, to make so they aren't very strong-willed, they don't have heart, they don't have strong moral values, so that these crimes against humanity can continue.
Again, it starts on the corporate level.
It's premeditated for, at times over 10 years. They calculate long-term plans, and it includes eugenics, people starving to death, people who are murdered, people who they could otherwise give aid to. And make sure the system wastes lots of money, and that money could have went to feed these people. It is nothing short of obvious murder. Who cares about the legality of it? It is clear-cut in reality, mass murder, mass rape, mass exploitation, mass drugging, and all these things. They're all working together, okay?
You know, when there's a gang indictment or a
mafia indictment, we see that they take them down together, and they assign blame accordingly. We do not see that with these corporations. I can't remember the last time a corporation had a criminal indictment where all the CEOs, all the business leaders and all the staff were arrested. It doesn't happen. There is a war on human decency and truth, and I'm the last good guy ever possible due to tech breeding and generational ill-gotten gains, generational lack of good generational logic, etc. Even education is
designed to keep people... to turn people to crime and disenfranchise
people with an emphasis on minorities, and it has to do with the particular ways, the specifics, the devils and the details that they do things. They don't figure out how people learn best. They don't allow black leaders in the society to take the black community. They don't allow Hispanic leaders, true leaders in society, to take these communities into the future. Just token minority devils, okay? The nations of the world know that basic religious truths prove that they are evil, logically, so some groups even sink to the level of arguing that evil doesn't exist. They work together to get people to fall in line while criticizing each other in a political game. Why keep breeding people who will go crazy
eventually, right? Playing the game.
Worldly life that is an animal life. The word animus means spirit and soul, okay? Because they're like animals, okay? The Bible refers to people as sheep and wolves because people are like animals being led by the worst monsters that ever existed.
The lowest forms of life that ever existed.
Governing class right now. Women are taught to be hypergamous. They take on witchcraft and shallow versions of Christianity. They're taught to date toward the core evils of society, to strive to be the immoral secretary of the slut elite. Look at San Jose, for example, east, west, south, you name it. You know, the poor women, middle-class women there, they would love to be a well-paid secretary for a piece of shit, okay, and have sex with it, all that, because they're whores, right? Horrible, okay, trick, showgirl, right? The trick, they're called tricks, they're showgirls, homegirls, okay, and so on and so forth. Escorts, right? It's the, you know, the holding court, and hookers, hook ear. So they hook them to who you're listening to, and then they get tricked, and they're tricks, and they're showgirls, putting on a show. They're not living in reality, because in reality, what they're doing is so unfathomably evil that no sane person would do it.
And part of the proof
is I'm around 40 years old. I've been studying women and dating for decades, okay? And I've been trying to get dates in the process, and I can assure you that there isn't a single attractive woman in
Santa Clara County,
and perhaps on the whole fucking country, that would give me a fair shake, okay, and a fair chance of dating. That's how much control the social clubs, the corporate groups, the political groups, the state wields over them. And if I don't act like a complete groupie fucking punk ass bitch, they won't give me the time of fucking day, even though I'm tall, dark, and handsome, the top martial artist ever, the son of two doctors, one a brain surgeon. It doesn't take a genius to see
that the problem isn't, oh, he just
can't get laid. That I'm fucking right to a T. And they need to stop being little clueless sluts, little showgirl whores, little lipstick airhead punk ass bitches. And they need to put morality and the content of the character far above rich demon trash and their punk ass subordinates. Okay? To not understand that I'm right about this means that you are an animal minded, dumb son of a bitch, coward ass, fool, namby pamby, pushover punk. Okay? And you shouldn't want to reproduce because you should want to spare the world your bitch-ass genes. Okay? On top of the fact that it's a pure, evil, mass-murdering world where people are in the spirit of mass murder, mass rape, child molestation, their political corporate partner alliances, political alliances, social club alliances, group of friends alliances to these ideas and spirits.
It is trickle-down, pure,
evil, abomination, bitch, spirit. Why do you people keep reproducing? Why do you guys keep saying babies when I go out? Why don't you people get that in 2021 the world is pure hopeless, pure evil, and it's political garbage on the most despicable level ever recorded in human history is playing out right now, and there's no hope for decency in the future because of who bred with who and why, and who lives what lifestyle and why? It's clear, 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 clear cut.